Hi there, I'm Chandra from Definitive Brands Group, and welcome to Quick Q&A, where we offer simple answers to frequently asked questions from our customers. Today we're going to be looking at the difference between ultrafiltration and reverse osmosis. This is a question we get quite frequently from our customers because reverse osmosis and ultrafilter systems tend to look quite similar. In this case, our reverse osmosis unit is made specifically for us, our own custom unit, so it does look a little bit different than our UF system and a lot of the others on the market, a lot of the other ROs on the market, but these differences will be consistent across different brands and different units. So the biggest difference between the two, firstly, is that an ultrafiltration unit tends to be a little bit cheaper, it tends to be a little bit more compact, and with the ultrafiltration unit, you'll have no water waste. Where a reverse osmosis unit offers better filtration, however, it does waste quite a lot of water as a domestic system. It does take up a little bit more space because even though the units are similarly sized, you would tend to have a buffer tank like this because the system runs through quite slowly, which I'll explain in a second. That makes sure that you have enough water to use if you want to open up a tap and fill up a glass. So the first three stages, which are these bottom three filters, on either side are the same. You typically have a sediment filter, a carbon block filter, and a GSE filter on either side. The next stage, which is your membrane stage, would be in your reverse osmosis unit, something like this, and in your ultrafiltration unit, something like this. So this is the largest or the most significant difference between the two. How this works, you can think about this as a very, very fine sieve. The water flows through your ultrafiltration tubes, and it's essentially filtered down to a very, very fine micron size. What that means is it will remove any suspended particles in the water, so very, very fine sediment, so very, very fine bits of sand, dust, rust, all of those sort of things that are floating around in the water, microplastics, and even bacteria, this will remove. However, it will not remove any dissolved minerals. So if you have, for example, dissolved iron in your water, it will not remove that. If you have viruses in the water, typically, this will not be able to filter small enough to remove viruses. If you have any dissolved salts in the water, this will not remove it, anything like that. So this is a great, very good value option. It offers very good water filtration. However, like I said, it's not going to remove brackish water, hard water, and very, very fine particles in the water. This, unfortunately, is not going to remove, but you are going to have no water waste. So it's a very effective system, and it doesn't come with a lot of the compromises that RO does. RO is a great system for good quality water. You'll find that most of your prepared bottled water goes through some sort of reverse osmosis process. This will remove close to everything out of your water. So the pre-filters will remove sediment, sort of chemicals in the water like chlorine, and when it gets to your reverse osmosis unit, it will go through a membrane like this. How this membrane works is water flows in from the one side, and it then flows through a semi-permeable membrane. Some of the water will flow through the membrane, and that's called your permeate, which is the clean water that you get out of the system. Some of the water will flow across the membrane to clean it. So you can think if it removes everything, including dissolved salts, that can pack up onto the membrane surface quite quickly. So you need water flowing across the membrane to keep on cleaning it and prevent the membrane from blocking up. That then flows out through your wastewater. So unfortunately, with these smaller domestic units that are not particularly efficient, so depending on your back pressure, depending on the pressure through to the system, you'll get anything between a 1:4 and a 1:8 waste to or product water to waste. So for every 1 liter of water that you get through the system that you use, you'll get somewhere between 4 and 8 liters of wastewater that gets flushed away. For a lot of people, that does seem quite inefficient, which unfortunately it is. But without that, generally these units won't be able to operate correctly. Some of the newer technology, so we do offer high flow membranes. They offer closer to a 1:1 waste and offer a higher throughput than these membranes as well, which is an optional accessory or an aftermarket filter change that you can do. But typically out of the box, these units are quite inefficient. Again, if you don't use a massive amount of water, it's not going to be a huge amount of water that you waste. And obviously for the quality of water you do get out of the system, it is a compromise that many people are willing to make. On the other side, with, like I said, with a reverse osmosis unit, these membranes flow through very slowly. So with a 50 gallon per day membrane, you're going to be looking at a flow rate of around 100 milliliters a minute, which is very, very slow for most people. So this is going to flow through to a tank like this. A tank like this typically holds around 3.2 gallons, which is around, or call it 10 liters. And what that's going to do is that's going to allow you to use that amount of water immediately when the tank is full. It usually takes about an hour for the tank to fill up. And you can then use that if you want to fill up a kettle, if you want to fill up a pot to cook something in, that water is then available immediately. The other downside to reverse osmosis is that even though if you have decent water pressure, you can typically install either of these just straight onto your water line. If you have very low water pressure, UF system typically will still work. So anything from 1 bar and up, you can connect this straight to your water line and the water should flow through without any issues. Unfortunately, with reverse osmosis, if you have anything below about 3 bar, you are going to need a system with a pump. We offer both of those as an option. The pump system, unfortunately, you're going to need power to use the system. The water will still flow through when there is no power, depending on the type of system that you buy. The basic systems do that. The slightly more expensive systems have a solenoid valve, which opens and closes, which requires power. And in that case, your system won't work if the power is out. But with the basic systems that just work straight on a booster pump, you're going to need a power point nearby your installation as well, which for many people is a little bit inconvenient. And you need to have an electrician extend that for you. So those are the main differences between these two systems. I hope that has answered most people's questions. If you do have any other questions, you're welcome to call our technical line. And we will link both of these products in the video description and up here in case you'd like to buy either of them.